GIS is a platform or software that helps you view, manipulate or analyse spatial data. By spatial data, I mean any sort of information that has a place attached to it, a location. GIS helps you visualise and represent that data, and through that you can then interrogate it how you wish.
GIS is a very important tool in our decision making. When any application comes in for development, we can compare it to the information on the GIS, and we can very quickly understand what heritage assets are going to be impacted or affected by this development.
One of the benefits of using GIS for us in our fieldwork is that having the access to lots of different data sets can help us to locate a site in the field much quicker. If we are just working from a map and a GPS, we don't have enough information all of the time to help us to locate to what might be a poor or low quality grid reference. So having more information in the field allows us to navigate to sites quicker.
GIS is an incredibly useful tool when you're thinking particularly about the macro scale impacts of climate change. So the climate change risk assessment that we carried out and published at the beginning of 2018 was a GIS-based project and analysis of susceptibility to natural hazards across our whole estates. We took the 336 properties in care and we determined what the susceptibility from hazards such as flooding, landslides and groundwater flooding was on these properties. And GIS allowed us to do that from an office in Edinburgh, because it's not possible for me to go and visit every single site. GIS lets us predict, in a sense, the sites that are most at risk and most susceptible, and then we can go and ground truth that data in a much more sensible and strategic manner.
It's absolutely fundamental being able to take all of your data out with a mobile device has made working with the data much more powerful, much more straightforward. You're not relying on static printouts, you're interactive with the data, you can combine and layer different sources of information. So mobile devices like the iPad and the pen computers or mobile phones are absolutely fundamental to really taking GIS for us in our work to the next level.
Well, if we didn't have GIS, our decision-making process would be a lot slower, because we would have to look at all this information on maps, physical maps, and we wouldn't have the ability to overlay all these other sources of information from different organizations.
GIS allowed us to interrogate different types of information. This provided quite a versatile planning tool for decisions to be made at a strategic level in regards to planning, in regards to effective maintenance and repair.
In order to start using GIS, the best place to start would be to speak to the GIS champion. The idea behind them is, you could almost say, cheerleaders for GIS within HES. We want to encourage people to use GIS, advise and direct people where we can. It's very much about making people aware that GIS exists and is a powerful tool that the organisation can use.